Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the World Away, and we've now got the next four stages of the Fanhome release of Build Your Own R2-D2. So we're going to be doing stages 11 to 14 now. Now in the last few stages we were creating the leg and we were also doing the dome section. Let me just show you what that looks like. This is the dome section up to now. I have taken the front eye off, which we did test fit in the last stage. And then we've got the leg, which kind of looks like that. We are going to be reinforcing that in the stages today. Now, if you want to get this for yourself, I've put the link down here to the Fanhome website. You can get this all the way from issue one. I do believe this is available in America now as well, but check out Fanhome's website and they'll be able to advise you accordingly. But without further ado, let's get cracking. So in stage 11, as you can see, we're going to be working more on the dome section. The most important section that we've got here, we're not actually putting together yet, which is this post. Now this post is going to enable us to make a stand that we can actually put the dome on eventually. We don't use that yet, but that will be coming in a later stage in this pack. So it's invaluable. Trust me, it's invaluable. So we've got lots and lots of screws here, but I'm going to put all of that to one side. We'll figure out the screws together. And we've also got some nuts here. And all we're going to do to start, we're going to take this panel, and this is going to the left hand side as I'm looking at it, to this panel that we've already put in. So this is just going to go into here like that. Now to put this in is exactly the same way as the screws we put in before. So we're going to need the nuts, and we're going to need the screws or the bolts, whatever you want to call them. It's the pack that silver screws has got the most screws in it. That's what we're going to use. So all we have to do is at the bottom there, we've got the outline of a nut. So I'm going to put a nut in there. Whoops. Just like that. Hold it with my finger. Load up a screw of a silver screwdriver and put that in. And make that nice and tight. And then we're just going to do exactly the same with the screw next to it, with the nut next to it. Screw, nut. I keep confusing them. After 6 years, you think I'd know. But no, keep confusing them. That's just me. And there's the second one going in like that. So with those two panels in, that's all there is to do in that stage. Bearing in mind, we do have loads of screws in this metal rod, which we do need to keep safe. Now, as you can see, in stage 12, we've got some more panels for the dome. We've got some more for the stand that we're going to be making, and we've got some leg braces there. So if I turn that over, the first thing we're going to do is put the panels on the dome, as you can see there. Then we're going to be attaching the reinforcement, which is the metal parts, for the leg. So the next part we're going to fit to the dome looks like that. We actually get two parts of the dome. Pretty easy to distinguish between them. One has got a smaller window on this side. We want the one with the two equal windows. And we're just going to continue working around the left here. So this one is going to go into this side here. And in the same way, drop a nut in, load a screw, and make that nice and tight. And just repeat that for the second one. And then that one's nice and tight as well. So that's looking like that. And then the last panel, just to the left again, this is going to go in here and just rinse and repeat. So with them two panels in, we're pretty much, well over halfway now with those going around. We can put that to one side because we're going to be bringing over the leg sections here, which, as you can hear, are metal. And for what we're about to do now, we also need the two leg frames, which were provided with issue 10. So I'm going to get those out as well. Now the parts are labeled up, so you can see this one here is LR15. We want to attach LR15 to LR16. So I'm just lining up what one's LR16, which is this one here. So this is just going to go over the top like that, fitting together a bit like a jigsaw puzzle. There you go. Now this time we want to screw these together with the screws that come in the pack looking like this. There's not as many of them this time. So I'm just going to get this open. These look slightly thicker than the screws we used before. Now we are going to need to put a nut on the other side. So once again, we've got the corresponding nuts here, which are slightly bigger. So as you can see, we've got a channel in there for a nut. We'll hold that in, hold it in with our finger, put the screw in, and then tighten that up. and that's the first one in. Then we're going to be putting the tab on here, which is going to join them both up. Now the tab's just going to go into this section here, but it's going to be facing with these pins facing down. That's just going to locate it. So the pins are going to be in the hole there. And once again, just like last time, drop a nut in, turn it over, and we're going to keep that into place here. So one screw in here. And one in the other side. There you go. Then in an exact similar fashion, we're just going to be piecing these two pieces together. So they go this way. They are labeled up. Let me just tell you, LR14 and LR13. And in a similar fashion, these are just going to go onto this side just here and held in once again with a nut and a screw. So that's one, and the last one in here. Is two. So when that's complete, that should look like that, and that's all there is to do in that stage. And in stage 13, as you can see, we're going to be putting the final two panels on the dome section that we've been working on. Now once again, in this pack we've got some items which aren't used. We've got a bit which is going to go on the underside of the dome, so we can keep that to one side, and we've also got the legs for the stand which we're shortly going to make, but I'll put that to one side as well. And the first panel we need looks like this. It's got a little indent on this side here, and just continuing what we done last time, following around to the left, this one is just going to go in here like that. Once again, a nut in there to hold it in place, screw the other side, and then just tighten that up. And do the same with the other hole on the other side. I'm getting a dab hand at this now. If you can imagine how many panels are on the R2-D2 unit, you'll see why you do become a little bit quicker at this. So once we've done that, we put the final panel in, which can only go in one place. It's the final place there. And again, nut this side, hold it with your finger, and then a screw just from the other side there. And just do the same for the other one. So when that's done, as you can see, we've got a full section of the top dome completed. Now we want to put this on a stand to protect it. We don't really want to leave it on the floor there. So we're going to actually build the stand now. So to make the stand, we've got this section here. What we're going to do is we're going to be putting this piece in first, which has got the tab on the center. It's going to make sure this goes through the center and this one sits on top. We'll put the other two in either side here. That's one and two. Then we're going to be screwing those in with the black screws that we had from a couple of stages ago. We've got them here. I'm going to take three of these. So that's one. Number two. And finally, number three. Put that way up and open up the big steel rod that we've got, which we can put down like that. And probably best on the side camera. We can then take the R2 unit, put that over the top, and now we can work on it while it's on the spindle there. But that's all there is to do in that stage. And in the last stage, stage 14, as you can see here, we're going to start making the ring, which is going to go underneath this dome section here. It's going to be going around this section here. We're also going to be creating some details for the R2-D2's right ankle. So there's absolutely loads of metal in this issue, and you can see now why R2-D2 is quite weighty when it's finished. But what we're going to do is we're going to take the two pieces of metal, DF18, and this one says DF19. This came in a previous pack. One of these plates did, and just put that together like that. Now we need to hold that into place, so we have got these little attachments there which are going to go over the top. We've got another one here which we're going to need to keep safe. We're not using that at the moment, but we are going to put that into place. And to do that, we've got the shorter screws, which we haven't opened yet, which look like that, silver ones here. These are quite short. And they're gonna be screwed in from the opposite side we've just put that tab in. So if I pick this up, they're gonna go in from this side here and just screw that till it's nice and tight. And we'll just repeat that on the other side here. That will hold those two panels into place, but we don't actually need to do anything with that now. So keep that safely to one side with this tab and these screws. Now we're gonna make these ankle details. So I'm just laying them out exactly as they go. And then all we're gonna do, turn these over, turn this one over as well, and it's gonna fit in here this way up. So it's gonna go in just like that. Now that's gonna be held in with a short black screw. Now we didn't get any short black screws in this pack, but I did check my box of screws from this and we do have them as a spare. So I've got that here. And I'm just going to put that in this side first. And that's the first one in. And quite simply, all we're going to do is just repeat that by putting this one here into that side, just in the complete opposite direction. Take one of the short black screws. And then that's just going to go in like this to hold that into place. So now we have these two details here. And that is all there is to do in that stage. So just to recap, we've done these parts here. We've done the leg brace, which will eventually go onto the leg. We've done the inner ring for the next level down on the dome section. And we've built the stand and completed the top section of the dome there, which can happily spin, no problems at all. But that's all there is to do in that pack. Now I'm hoping by building the R2-D2 again, I'm helping you with some of the screws that you need, because I am aware the screws aren't labeled. So hopefully it's making it a little bit easier now. Plus I've got far more cameras on the system now, so you'll be able to see quite close up exactly what I'm doing. But I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.